You know, we started this work about 8 years ago, and I didn't know what collagen was.
I thought it was in my jello.
Collagen, first of all, it's the most abundant human protein by far. It's about 30% by weight. And to understand the processes by which it's remodeled and restructured are really crucial to understanding a lot of human physiology and then also disease. My name is Keir Neuman. I'm a senior investigator in the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute at the National Institutes of Health. My field of research is single molecule biophysics. Think of a suspension bridge and that steel cabling that holds up the suspension bridge. It's not a bad analogy for collagen within the human body. And like steel cabling, we thought it to be inert. It was worked on, but didn't really participate in that process. We're experimentalists, and so when you want to figure something out, you take the next step, you make the next measurement. We expected it to be sort of a random binding. By following the motion of the enzyme, we discovered that it first binds periodically, and then to our surprise, this periodic structure actually moves, and what this told us was that it wasn't the enzyme dictating all this, it was in fact the collagen. The collagen was dictating where the enzyme was binding and how it began that process of degradation. But over time, this periodic pattern shifted. So instead of the collagen being this rigid steel cabling within the cell, what we discovered was actually, it was highly dynamic. What that allows us to do in a larger sense is understand how does the enzyme get access to the cleavage sites. So I put on my physics hat and I was thinking about what on earth is like this, and I came upon mud. Mud, as it's drying, there's internal strain that builds up. And when that strain is relieved by cracking, that's identical, we think, to what's happening in the collagen fibril. So much akin to mud cracking, the collagen can crack, expose these sites where the enzyme can bind, initiate degradation. And unlike mud, the collagen can reheal and crack someplace else. And that's why this pattern is essentially dynamic. It moves through time. There are several diseases and physiological problems that are associated with collagen degradation and collagen remodeling. For example, cancer metastasis involves the degradation of collagen. By understanding this process at a much deeper level, we may be able to shed some insight and help develop either treatments or cures for some of these afflictions.